Parashat Balak, Bil'am wants to curse the Jewish people, as does Balak, but in the end Hashem, by force, converts and transforms his curses into blessings. So he actually blesses the Jewish people. After blessing three times over, then Balak already gives up and tells him to go home. But before going home, he says, I'm going to reveal to you what this people is going to do to you in the end of days. And then he begins a series of prophecies. That the most important or most well-known phrase is Darach Kochav Miyakov, that a star will appear and shoot through the sky from Jacob, meaning from the people of Israel. Who is that star that will appear and shoot through the sky? So according to one Midrash of Chazal, that star is King David, that will appear in the future. The Rambam also explains that that star, Darach Kochav Yaakov, is David Melech Yisrael HaVekayam, Jacob, who is alive in all generations. But he first appeared on the screen of history in his day, and that's what Chazal say, that is a prophecy referring to David. Other places in Chazal say that it's referring to Mashiach, who is the descendant of David, and the Talmud Yerushalmi, his proper name is David, just like David. He is the full David, and the original David is just a half Caesar, a half Caesar, a half David. So either it's referring to David or referring to the Mashiach, David or Mashiach. But then there is a third understanding of Chazal, of the sages, and it's based upon a story that's told in the Talmud, referring to dreams and dream interpretation. That once a goy, a non-Jew, it says in the Gemara, came to Rabbi Yishmael, Rabbi Yossi, and he said, I had a very strange dream last night. Maybe you can help me interpret it. I dreamt that I swallowed a star. Balati kocha, that's a real interesting dream, that he swallowed a star. So immediately Rabbi Yishmael, Rabbi Yossi, says to him, you swallowed a star in your dream. You killed a Jew. You're a murderer. And it came out in the end, he confessed that he really did kill a Jew. And that to swallow a star is to kill a Jew, if a goy swallows a star. So what have we learned from this? We learned that, and he brought, yeah, how do I know that to swallow a star is to kill a Jew? Because of this verse, Darach Kochav Miyakov. So how is he reading, interpreting this verse? He's interpreting that every Jew is a star. How do I know simply from the Torah that every Jew is a star? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu took Abraham, our first patriarch, out of his tent, and he said, look up at the heavens and count the stars. Can you count them? So shall be your seed. So also we see explicitly that every Jew is a star. I mean, the whole Jewish people is a people of stars. But when Rabbi Yishmael, Rabbi Yossi brought a quotation in his dream interpretation, he brought it from this, from the verse in this week's Parashah, not from the story of Abraham. He brought it from Darach Kochav Miyakov. So what does it mean that every Jew is a star? And the star refers to David, the King David, David HaMelech, and also refers to the Mashiach himself. So it must mean that there's a continuation here, that it all goes together. We know that the Rebbe liked the word miyad, which means immediately, that always would bless and say very forcefully that the Mashiach should come techafu miyad mamash, immediately in our days. That word immediate, miyad, he gave different rashi tevot. He explained it in different ways, that it stands as an acronym for different names. So in our particular case, we also have now a very beautiful example of miyad, that it's Mashiach Yehudi David. The three interpretations of who that star is that is appearing and shooting through the sky, who it's referring to. Is it referring to Mashiach, or to every Jew, or to King David? obviously they're all related, all one. And their initials are Miyad. To meditate that every single Jew is a star in the sky, and a star that appears and shoots through the sky is a very, very important and deep meditation. The whole Jewish people, as a people, as a congregation, is likened to the moon. When Hashem created the world, He created the moon together with the stars. He created one great luminary, which is the sun. The sun represents, in a certain sense, Shemesh Havaya. It symbolizes, in a certain sense, Hashem. The moon is the Jewish people. They are a pair. The stars are all of the individual Jewish souls. And each star is intended to appear and shoot across the sky in its time. In Pirkei Avot we read, every man has his hour, his special hour, that his star shoots and appears in the sky of the world, the sky of history. It's his time to appear. It's his time, his moment, to assume his messianic role in life. That's every single Jew. There are many, many beautiful gematriot about the word star. Star is written Kochav, Kafav is 26, which is Hashem's name, and Kafbet is 22, which are the letters of the alphabet of the Torah. I mean, there's something in the word Kochav, the first allusion that it unites God with the Torah. Oraita v'kuchabriyot kul achad. Actually, when you meditate on the word Kochav, you can see this in two different ways. Either the first two letters are Kafav, which is 26, which is Hashem, and the second two letters are Kafbet, which is 22, which are the 22 letters of the Torah. That's the number that represents the Torah. Or that you can see that the Vav Kaf are the two middle letters, and the two extreme outer letters are the Kafbet, meaning that Hashem is inside the Torah. So either Hashem is first and the Torah is second, or Hashem is inside the Torah. So these are both ways to meditate on the spelling of the word Kochav. The whole phrase, Darach Kochav Miyakov, itself is a multiple of 26. It equals 19 times 26, 494. Darach Kochav Miyakov. The star shoots through the sky from Jacob. Darach Kochav Miyakov, 494, 19 times 26. When Hashem's name, which equals 26, is spelled in full, so the inner letters, the pregnant and hidden letters equal 19. It's 26 and plus the 19 equal man. Atem Kriyim Adam. Man refers to Israel. So here it's taking the hidden part of the Rai, which is 19, and multiplying it by the revealed part of the Rai, which is 26, and that gives Darach Kochav Miyakov. Another beautiful allusion. What happens if I multiply the letters? Instead of adding them together, the word Kochav, it has four letters. 26, 22. So instead of adding them together, I have 26 and 22 is 48. Because the normative gematria of Kochav is 48. 26 plus 22. But what happens if I'll calculate the product of the four letters, which is 20 times 6 times 20 times 2. So very amazingly, this does not occur for almost any other word in the Torah, in the world, in Hebrew, that I will get 4,800. Meaning that the product of the letters is exactly 100 times the sum of the letters. The sum of the letters is 48, and the product of the letters is 4,800. Meaning that every star, every Jewish star, has in itself the potential of 100 stars. What does it mean, 100 stars? That every soul has the inter-inclusion of 10 powers, and each one of the 10 powers is once more has its inter-inclusion of 10 powers. How do we reveal that phenomenon of 100 in one? It says by making 100 blessings every day. A person, a Jew, were supposed to make 100 blessings, bless Hashem 100 times every day. That reveals the 100 stars in each star. So let's just conclude with saying that nowadays in English and from English and other languages, when you speak of a star is the greatest person on stage. The stage is the stage of history. The stars that are playing the game, the players of the play, the stars of the play are the Jewish people and every individual Jew. There are other players, but they're not the stars. The other players are the non-Jews. But the stars are the Jews. And the star is that every Jew has his messianic potential that is revealed in his hour.